वेलकम टू पायनियर ऑफ सक्सेस। हियर आई एम बैक विद अ न्यू लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन कॉमसॉल मल्टी फिजिक्स। दिस पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर सीरीज इज डिजाइन फॉर रिसर्चर्स। सो बिफोर गोइंग टू द टेक्निकल डिटेल्स ऑफ दिस लेक्चर सीरीज, आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू टू सब्सक्राइब टू माई चैनल एंड हियर इज समथिंग अबाउट माई सेल्फ। सो दिस पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर सीरीज आर कवरिंग मेनी थिंग्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू talk about strategies related to taking up a physical problem. So this is very much important for the people who have just started their research career taking computational domain and using COMSOL Multiphysics as a research tool. And other topics which I will be covering in this particular series are fluid flow related research problems. Then I will take up microfluidics related research problems. Also, I'll be talking about electrokinetics related research, hydrodynamic and thin film instability. And the most important thing is that I'll be covering electrochemistry, electrical double layer formation, supercapacitor related research problems. So basically, I will be covering the things so that you can start working on this particular problem, taking COMSOL Multiphysics as a tool of your research. And also I'll be talking about wave optics related research problems. So that will be going in a way that I'll be teaching you the basics of optics, I'll be teaching you basics of microfluidics, basics of thin film instability, and how to model those problems in COMSOL. And after getting this particular idea, you'll be able to take up your research problem. Also, we are free to do any collaborations, and anybody can write to us for any kind of collaboration with us. So in this particular lecture, I'll be covering how to tackle a particular research problem. So I have broken this particular problem into four steps. So whenever you are dealing with a problem, you should divide it into four particular steps. That is my suggestion. So the first step should be understanding the research problem without any knowledge gap. What does that mean? It means you should understand the physical problem before you try to model it. So whatever is happening, that should be clear in your mind, and you should be thinking about the problem. So that you can go to the next step, and the next step is clear understanding of the differential equation that will guide the physical problem. So as I already told, initial step is understanding the phenomenon. So once you understand the phenomenon, you should have the ability to make differential equations out of this knowledge, that phenomenon you know. Now you know the differential equation. Okay, this is the phenomenon, so I'll be taking this particular equation and or those set of equations. So those things should be clear in your mind. So once the things are clear, then you have to spend some time on identifying relevant physical boundary conditions. Selection of boundary conditions are as much important as the differential equation selection. So there are few people who think that once we know the differential equation, then the game is over. But this is not the case. You have to understand the differential equation, and then the most important part is understanding the boundary conditions. And that would be the boundary conditions should be relevant to your problem. If you know the boundary conditions, then only the entire problem definition is set and you can go ahead. And the last part, which is also important, I call it stage 4, that is feasible values of boundary conditions, space and time are also important. That means whichever topic you have taken, that should have a particular time and physical space. So what would be the dimension of the physical space? How long time you should take for this particular simulation? Those ideas you should have in your mind. So this fourth stage will tell you about your ability, and if you are well aware of these four steps, then you can right away go with your problem statement. So for understanding this particular idea that I have divided into four steps, I have taken a simple problem. So the first problem is I have taken a simple diffusion equation. You can see here, this is a simple diffusion equation. So what I am doing, I am trying to solve this diffusion equation. So if I solve diffusion equation, what I will be getting? I will be getting a profile. So the first one is simple one, that is a one dimensional case. So what I have taken a simple line. So in this particular problem, the physical phenomenon is you have a situation where this part has higher concentration and the last part has the lower concentration. So we have to know the concentration distribution along this line with respect to time. So this is the physical problem. So now, as I already told, the physical problem is I have to see the profile along this line with respect to time. So there is a thing, the time is associated with this problem, and that is why I have taken unsteady one. And what am I dealing with? I am dealing with a diffusion. So that is why this term diffusion has been taken up. So this is the physical understanding, and the physical understanding I am translating into the differential equation. So whatever physical understanding I had, I have translated it into my differential equation. Now, few more things you have to understand. In this case, the problem is there is a silent situation going on. There is no external flow, there is no external field acting on this particular case. And that is why this equation is this much simple. There is no convective term. There is no other force terms or something. So this is a very simple case. Now I have to go to the next step. That is my first part, physical phenomenon understanding is over. A differential equation has been set up. So now I have to think about the boundary conditions. So I have already told my physical problem was the left part has higher concentration and the right part has lower concentration. So what I do, I keep a particular concentration at the left part and also at the right part. So left part, that is x equal to 0, it has been taken as C0, and then in the right part, that is at x equal to L, it has been taken as C equal to L. It should be understood that this C0 is higher than CL. So there will be a gradient along this direction, positive x direction, and that is why component will be flowing from x equal to 0 to x equal to L. So this is a physical understanding. So the third step is also over. I have taken up this problem, and I have also defined the boundary conditions. So there are two boundary conditions needed for this particular problem, because this order of the differential equation is 2. So the two boundary conditions are those. And also you have to understand that there is a time related term. So you'll be needing an initial boundary condition. So I'll show you during the COMSOL simulation that initial boundary condition has been taken up. Now the fourth step. Now, as we have already covered initial three steps, I am going to the fourth step. The fourth step is understanding about the time and space. So what am I dealing with? I am dealing with a diffusion problem. So in diffusion problem, we have the process is very slow. That is why we have taken a very small dimension. I have taken 1 millimeter dimension for solving this differential equation. Again, I am telling why am I taking 1 millimeter, because the diffusion process is very slow. So this idea I already have in my mind from my experience. So my experience is telling that 1 millimeter is a feasible dimension. So that is the understanding of the space. Now I have to calculate the time. So I have already qualitatively told you that the time is very small. Diffusion process is very, very slow. That means it takes longer time. But what would be exact times, that I do not know. So here I am calculating the time scale. The time scale can be given for this diffusion problem as L square by D, where L is the characteristic length. Here 1 millimeter will be taken up for the characteristic length, and D is the diffusivity. So I have assumed that I am solving for a liquid diffusion. So liquid diffusion, that is a component diffusivity, falls in the order of 10 to the power minus 9. So I have taken D as 10 to the power minus 9. And length was 1 millimeter, that means 10 to the power minus 3 meter. So I am just putting these values to get this value of tau. So tau is, I am getting 1000, and 1000 second, that this is second. 1000 second means 1.66 hour. So the time which I should be taking in my simulation should not be very small. Like, you cannot solve for 1 nanosecond, because in 1 nanosecond nothing will happen. So for this particular problem, 1 nanosecond should not be taken. 1 millisecond should not be taken, because the time domain is falling in hour. So what I should be taking, I should be taking at least 1 hour or at least 30 minutes. So I'll show you in COMSOL in the later part of this video. And the next problem is, as I already told, it was a one-dimensional problem. Now I am moving from one-dimensional to two-dimensional problem. So I am increasing the complexity of the problem. Initially, it was very simple, only diffusion equation and one-dimensional. Now I am taking in two dimensions. So you already know, in two dimension, we will be needing another term. So that term has been added, that is del square c del y square. So another coordinate has been added. So in two dimension, this is a plane. So this plane is being shown by this rectangular block. And in this rectangular block, what we are suggesting, at every wall we will be having a particular concentration of a particular analyte, and we have to solve the concentration profile inside this rectangular block. So that is the main problem. So we know the concentration at every block. So one interesting thing is here, in this case I need four boundary condition. One is for this, because this has a second order with respect to x, so I will be needing two boundary conditions for this one. Again, for this one we'll also need another two boundary conditions. So I have already taken four constant concentration, so that is satisfying my problem. I have a well set up problem. I have taken four boundary condition. I'll be taking the initial condition, and that one I'll be telling you during the COMSOL simulation. So in case of 2D, what I have to do, I have to take a two-dimensional frame where I'll be discussing, I'll be setting all the boundary conditions, and the same problem I can solve. So this was all about the background of the today's video. Now we'll be going to the COMSOL interface to see how I will be taking the same things in a COMSOL interface. So before going to the COMSOL interface, I'd like to request you to subscribe to my channel, and thank you for your attention. And again, I'm telling, please feel free to write to us for any kind of research collaboration. We'll be happy to be collaborating with you. Thank you. In this part, I'll be talking about modeling with COMSOL. In the first part of the video, I have told you about four steps to be followed in modeling COMSOL multiphysics problem. So I'll be taking both the problems which I have talked about in the initial part of the video, and that was one-dimensional unsteady diffusion problem and two-dimensional unsteady diffusion problem. In order to model it in COMSOL interface, I have to open COMSOL multiphysics, and then you'll get an option model wizard. You have to click on it. Once you click on it, there will be options like this. So this is the options for, those are the options for taking dimension. If it is a three-dimensional problem, I have to take three-dimensional, but the first problem will be dealing with 1D. So I take 1D, I click on it, then I have to take diffusion equation. So I have to understand in which physics the diffusion equation is mentioned. So that knowledge I have, that is mentioned in chemical species transport. So I expand it. Under chemical species transport, there are many options. So I have to take transport of dilated species. So I click on it, then I click on add. So once I add it, two times I have added, so I have to remove once. Yeah, so I have added transport of dilated species, and then I have to go to study. I click on study, then I will click on time dependent, because my problem was unsteady one. Unsteady means a time dependent problem. So I click on time dependent, and then I click on done. Yeah, so for initial interface, I have taken transport of dilated species and time dependent problem. Now I have to go to geometry. I have to define my one dimensional space where I will be solving the equation. So I right click on it. I take option interval. You can see here the dimension, it is asking in meter, but meter will be very much, and I have already talked about it. The fourth point, that you should have understanding about the space. So the space should be in millimeter. So I go to geometry again. I change the option from meter to millimeter. Then again go to interval. So now I have chosen 1 millimeter. So I click on build selected. So it will be taking one line, and the length of the line would be 1 millimeter. So I have taken a line of 1 millimeter. Now I go to transport of diluted species. I look into the equation. You have to expand here. So the equation will be shown. So this is the equation COMSOL Multiphysics has automatically taken up. So now what I have to do? I have to make it my desired equation. So you can see here, there is one option that is coming because of convective term. But I already told convective term I have not taken. So I have to uncheck it. The convection term is coming from here. It is already checked by default. I have to uncheck it. Once I uncheck it, this option will not be shown. So it has gone. Now, another term is reaction term. It will be there automatically. But if you do not take any reaction, it will be zero. So ultimately, if it becomes zero, then your equation, this equation is nothing but fixed equation. That is the unsteady diffusion equation. So now this equation is my equation, what I have already talked about in the initial part of the video. Now I have to take two boundary conditions, which I have already mentioned. So I right click on it, then there will be an option concentration. You click on concentration. So left part I have to select. So I go here, I click on the left portion. It will be asking for the value. I check it, species C. Say I take concentration of 10 mole per meter cube at the left part. Again I right click on it, I choose concentration. Now I have to choose concentration of the right part. So I go to here, I click on it. Again it will be asking, say this concentration is 1 mole per meter cube. So I have taken two boundary condition. In the left part it is 10 mole per meter cube, in the right part it is 1 mole per meter cube. So there is a concentration difference. Now my two boundary conditions are given, and I have talked about initial conditions. So initial values are given here. So my boundary conditions are set. I have taken the differential equation in COMSOL. Now I will be going to mesh. I have to mesh this space. So I go for fine meshing. I click on build all. So you can see those are the points. So I make it more close. So I click on finer, build all. You can click on extreme fine and build all. So those are the points the COMSOL will be solving the equations. So now all the things are set. I go to study, time dependent study. It is asking for range. Now this range I have talked about. I have to take a time up to 1 hour or so, because I have already calculated the time scale for this particular problem. But here automatically it is showing 0 to 1 second with an interval of 0.1. So I have to change it. I make it 0, an interval of 60 seconds. I go up to 600, that means 1 hour. 600 seconds, that means you can go up to, yeah, six for the timing we simulate up to 600 seconds. Now I go to study, I click on compute, the simulation is running. Yeah, so this is the concentration profile with respect to time. This is a plot autom by default it is there. That is a line graph. What I am plotting, I am plotting concentration with respect to, I mean concentration versus space, that is 0 to 1 at different time. So if you go here, if you click on legends, you can see this blue line is for 0 second, this is for 60 second, this line. So as time progresses it is becoming like this. So now 600 seconds was almost good for studying this particular problem. In initial calculation I made it 1 hour, but up to 600 seconds also some diffusion process will take place, and that is sufficient for this particular problem. So here the profiles are very nice, and we are getting it by solving a simple problem, taking a length where we are solving the diffusion equation with appropriate boundary condition. Now I'll show you the two dimensional case. So again I go to new model wizard. Now I have to take 2D. I click on transport of diluted species, add it, then go to study, then time dependent. I am clicking on done. Now I am taking it in millimeter, as I have already done in the first case. Right click on it, I take one rectangle. Let the height 2 millimeter as I have shown in the initial part of the video and width 1 millimeter build selected. So this is the solution space. Then I go to transport of the diluted species. Again in equation this term is there, so I uncheck convection. It becomes my desired equation. Again right click on it. I put concentration. I have to define concentration of all the walls. So this wall, say I keep at 50 mole per meter cube. Again I take concentration, right click and take concentration. So this part I define, this part, say this is 80 mole per meter cube. For say I have to define two more concentration, so I again right click. So this wall I select, again I keep it at say some concentration 30 mole per meter cube. The last concentration I have to select for this wall, I keep it at low concentration, say 10. So I have defined four different concentration. Initial conditions are already defined. Now I have to go to mesh. I go for finer mesh, build all. This is not good. I go for extra fine. This is relatively good. Then I have to go to time. Again I solve for 600 seconds. So I change the range from 0, 60 interval up to 600 seconds. I click on compute. The simulation is running and this is the profile of concentration. You can see this is a nice profile we are getting. So this is how you have to do 2D simulations. Now one thing which I mentioned in the fourth point, I'll show you. If I would have taken the geometry in meter, that means the dimensions are 1 meter and 2 meter. I click on build all. So it has become 1 meter. You can see it is in meter. Then again I click on study with keeping other parameters same. You can see the profile has not developed because the dimensions are very long. Diffusion cannot take place so fast that within 600 seconds it could cover 1 millimeter. That's why I told you about the fourth point. The space is very important. If you choose a wrong space or wrong time scale, you will not reach to your solution. And sometimes simulation may not run. So you have to understand about the time and physical space. And that is very much important for all your simulation. So thank you very much for your attention. And I request you to subscribe to my channel. And also I'm free to do any kind of collaborations. If you have any research problem to discuss with me, you can write me an email. Thank you very much.